In the previous video, we created a simple crowd with CrowdFX in Softimage and explained some of its basic concepts. In this video, we'll change the behavior of the actors by adding more instances of actors, adding goals, and changing the actor's speed. We'll also look at how an actor's animation is handled by CrowdFX. The actors are being emitted from a directional grid that was created automatically with the new pedestrian crowd command. You could also add other objects as emitters, but we'll cover that in another video. Let's move the emitter over to the corner of the plaza, making sure to keep the emitter on the ground plane. We'll also rotate the grid so that at emission time, the actors move in the direction of the fountain. And we'll increase the size of the grid so that it covers more of the plaza. You can see that the same number of actors is emitted as before, just spread out a bit more. The number of actor instances is actually the number of particles in the crowd's point cloud, as defined in the emit and initialize ice tree. Let's increase the number of particles to 40 in the emit node and play back. You see that the actors are all moving towards this little red thing in the scene, which is the goal object that was created automatically with the new pedestrian crowd command. Goals are special objects that actors always move toward, like a magnetic force. After actors reach their final goal, they just generally keep moving around it unless you tell them to do something else. We can add another goal object with the crowd add goal command. The next available index number is automatically used to identify the goal when it gets created. The actors move from one goal to the next following the index's numerical order, so you can move the goals around as you like to define the crowd's flow. Make sure to keep the goals on the ground plane when you move them so that the actors will be able to detect them. The actors move first to goal 0. When they reach it or get close to it, they start moving toward goal 1. You may have noticed that the actors are running through the fountain, which is probably not the best idea if they want to keep their suits dry. We'll fix this in the next video, but first let's look at how CrowdFX handles animation for the actors. We can see the animation sources that we loaded for the actor by choosing Actors, Inspect Actor Proxies. Select the actor in the list, then click the Inspect Animations button. You may have many action sources available for this actor, but only these selected actions are used in the crowd simulation. While we're here, let's hide our original character, just so that he's out of the way. The Get Animation Sources tree is where these action sources are referenced. Then, the sources are referenced by the animation states that are defined and blended in the Animation Blending tree. Open the Animation Definition node to see that each source is defined in one of two types of animation state nodes. These animation states were created automatically for us because we created our crowd with the new pedestrian crowd command. However, if you create a crowd from scratch, you have to create the animation states yourself using these nodes to be able to use action sources in the crowd. Any type of stationary action is defined as an idle state in a Define Animation State node. If you had several stationary actions, you could blend them inside this node. You can set a state to be loopable, such as if it's a standing around type of action that you want to keep repeating, as we have here. Or set the action to play once, such as if it's a fall down and die type of action that you probably don't want to be repeated. Movement type actions, such as walking or running, are defined as the move state in the Define Move Animation State node. Some automatic blending is done between any movement actions referenced in this node. Once you've defined your states, the Define Animation State Transition node determines how the transition happens between each state according to the speed of the actor. And speaking of the actor's speed, let's change that now in the behavior tree. This tree is like the brains for the actors. It's where you define the logic for how the animation states are used and how the actors react to each other and to their environment. To alter the actor's speed, open the Set Velocity using Collision Avoidance node and set the target speed value. This value is the highest speed that the particles try to reach in the simulation, which is the number of Softimage units per second. You can see that it affects how quickly the actors move forward in space. The target speed also affects the playback speed of the animation cycles in the action sources we loaded. For example, the run animation cycle speed is faster when you increase the target speed value so that the animation stays proportional to the velocity of the particles. It would look rather odd if the particles were moving quickly, but the actor's legs weren't. This is all done thanks to a secret solver inside the Define Move Animation State node. It takes the actor's velocity into account to change the playback speed of the animation in the move state. We'll set the target speed to 30 so that they're running at a good clip, but not going too fast. Obviously, they're not that anxious to get to the meeting. The target speed is also used to determine which animation state is used, as you can see with the logic that's set up in the behavior tree. If the target speed is greater than 0.1, if true, you use the move animation state, which refers to both the walking and running actions in our setup. If the target speed value is less than 0.1, if false, the actors switch to their idle state, which is the stand idle action in our setup. Of course, you can change this value and also the logic in this tree to create any sort of behavior you want, which we'll explore in more detail in other videos. In the next video, we'll add some obstacles so that our actors stop running through that fountain, and then send the final crowd simulation to Maya.